Happening now, investigators continue to work to determine what caused a plane with seven people on board to crash into Percy Priest Lake. Both engines and more human remains were recovered on Monday. Julia Palazzo joins us live now from Percy Priest Lake in Rutherford County to explain what investigators will be looking for as they search for answers.
Yeah, not too far away from us up the lake. That's where crews have been focused on. It's the area between the Lamar boat ramp where we are standing and the Weekly Lane Bridge. And the medical examiner's office did confirm that three females and four males were on that plane based on evidence found. But the investigation is far from over. We witnessed on Monday morning a big active scene, a barge carrying a crane and an underwater drone. Divers were also on site. Christopher Hart, former chairman of the National Transportation Safety Board, gave us some insight into the investigation. They utilize regional investigators from the NTSB who look at every aspect of the operation. Evidence is collected and witnesses are interviewed. The wide debris field and the water certainly will be a challenge. After finding the facts, they move into the analytical phase. Investigators typically stay on scene 4 to 7 days, and they heavily rely on local law enforcement to be successful.
We couldn't do what we do without their help because they're the first on scene. They protect the scene so that no evidence will be stolen. So they protect it from, while we're investigating it, they protect it from people, you know, onlookers just getting in the way. And so we are tremendously indebted to the local authorities who are not only the first responders if necessary to help rescue people, but also to help us by protecting the scene.
So the Lamar boat ramp is officially open today, which is where we are, not too far away from that plane crash site. But the Fate Sanders Recreation Area, that is where all of the crews have been staged since the very beginning. That is closed off and will be closed until further notice. We'll talk more about what's next in the investigation coming up in our next half hour. Reporting live in Rutherford County, Julia Palazzo, News 2.
Well, the people on board the plane were leaders of the Remnant Fellowship Church in Brentwood. It was founded back in 1999 by best-selling author Gwen Shamblin Lara. She is one of the victims of this crash. Her husband Joe, who was also on board, was an actor best known for his role in the TV series Tarzan, The Epic Adventures, Baywatch, and the Gunsmoke movie. David and Jennifer Martin were also on board at the time of the crash. They've been with the church since it was founded, and so were Jessica and Jonathan Walters. Brandon Hanna was Shamblin's son-in-law and had four children with her daughter Elizabeth. We'll continue to follow the latest developments on this deadly plane crash and pass them along to you both on air and online. We'll update WKRN.com and, of course, our app around the clock.